This is Abhay from CIIT NCERT New Delhi. I will moderate this webinar today with my colleague Dr. Nidhi Singh. We are also celebrating Ambedkar Jayanti today, and NCERT is starting a quiz for school children on Indian Constitution from today. Please visit our website for further information. On behalf of myself and CIIT, I pay my respectful homage to Baba Sahib Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar on his birth anniversary today. Baba Sahib lived to integrate equality, liberty, and fraternity into our social and political democracy. And it so happens today that today's topic of webinar on open educational resources is all about freedom. Richard Stallman, guru of free software movement, has termed the use of free software, especially in schools, as an issue of morality and ethics, in the sense that we want our children to be sharing, collaborating, and dwelling in freedom rather than with the prisoners of protectionism as practiced by the proprietary software. So to speak on this topic of open educational resources, we have with us Dr. Manas Ranjan Panigrahi, who is a senior program officer with Commonwealth Education Media Center for Asia, SEMCA, New Delhi. I welcome Dr. Panigrahi to today's session of webinar. Dr. Manas does not need any introduction, as he can be found leading important events of SEMCA, especially on OERs across the country. He brings with himself a great diversity of experiences of working in several capacities, both in India and abroad. I hope we will be immensely benefited from him.
I would request Dr. Manas to please start his session on OER. Dr. Manas.
Thank you very much, Nidhi, and thanks to Dr. Abhay and introducing me. Not like that, very known to that. I'm just a learner and I'm learning along with you people all. And I can see here 483 people already joined this webinar. I'm happy to that. I welcome all of you to this webinar. And
just to interfere, sir, we are also going live on YouTube. So you are also visible on our YouTube channel. So those who could not join, who haven't joined, you can tell your friends to watch it on YouTube channel as well.
Yeah. So it's very, very good that this is another ambience that people can join live through YouTube channel, and they can see me, and we can also interact with each other directly. And through this webinar, we will learn together and what we are exactly practicing and how we are practicing. That we can see in this particular, there is no need of the much introduction towards the talking about there are various festivals and occasions today in single day. I am really grateful that NCERT invited me and giving me this opportunity to speak about this open educational resources, and particular reference to the that is reflected towards open license. We will talk step by step the things, and but I can say here one sentence, we all are open today. We can feel in this particular situation, last 21 days we are at home, and I believe so my all colleagues, those who joined and those who are watching this webinar, they are in their respective places and making themselves hygiene, and they are also helping each other to be safe, staying at home and following the procedures and directive of the governments time to time to fight against this COVID-19 in India as well as in world perspective. So thank you very much again to CIIT and NCERT giving me this opportunity. I'm moving towards my presentation. Friends, as we know, we are now this period of time, you believe me and you will be with me in that page that I have seen lot of WhatsApp sharing. I have seen many Facebook sharing with videos, texts and presentations and many informations which we are sharing very easily and frequently. Have you seen and have we think that what we are sharing really it is shareable? Am I have that right to share these informations? Let us see and just keep this words in your mind and compare with my during my presentation that really we are in the right page or not. Being a teacher, being a student, being a learner, being a lifelong learner, we know the word is called copyright. Many places, many situations, we always looking towards this one, all rights reserved with the copyright sign. It restricts access to education and research and limits innovations. I'm sure, but I don't know about you. Are you with me? Are you sure about it? Let us check and let us see how we are moving into. So, you please see expensive for the users. For me, it's expensive for the users. Limited or no access to quality. Lot of textbooks is available and we are unable to access them. So as a result, dropout in higher education. Particularly, you can look into that one. Not time consuming production of the resources. Copyrighted materials, we need to take care of all respect. If you are not taking care of all respects of the producing of a textbook or any kind of book or any kind of educational materials, it's really, you can think that this is the required lot of time, lot of energy, many resources, and sometimes it is repeated investment on the similar educational resources. In an author of you, author of me, author of X and Y, Z. I'm writing, no doubt. I'm writing in my way, you are writing in your way, but contents are similar to nature and we are producing these contents. Beginning of the process to end the process. So repeated investment, the way we are writing, we are producing the contents and resources. Low scalability, less efficiency. Limited or no access to the quality research data or articles. You can look into this, you can easily understand the situation, which is slow innovation from social point of view. This is the system which is in the closed environment. It's in a closed environment. If I'll talk about this one, what happens to copyrighted resources in 21st century learning environment? We are know that we are dealing with 21st century learners. I am 21st century learner. You are 21st century learners. What happens to the copyrighted resources? Very simple example I wanted to quote with you. use infringement, cannot restrict the use of the digital content once it is online, as we are doing right now. As we are downloading many things without understanding about its closeness. See the example. This example, this girl downloaded 200,000 content materials every day. She's from Kazakhstan and she was cut by the court. She was downloading and doing illegal in act. But logic was in a different safe. Or sees that the contents are available on internet, so that's why I'm taking this opportunity, downloading these contents and using my purpose and sharing with my friends and other people, those who want this content. See, this is the thing which is taking towards the open. That open is still called as not encourageable for the legal point of view. See, her logic is that very low, zero distribution cost. Why still expensive? Because contents are available. Movement against the unjust trend seeking of the publishers over the educational resources. You see, I need these contents to reuse, revise, remix, redistribute, and retain the content as e-learning got popularity. From that point of view, those things are come multiple way how we can reduce all these things and content can be available to all, which can be usable, which can be shareable, which can be revisable, and again, which can be retainable for your learning. The concept of all things make more popularization from this incident and moving towards the situation. I would like to share with you some more experiences that status of the student in this era in 21st century. Commonwealth of Learning does a survey in 2016, access to this resources, educational resources, particularly in this things which is looking into. 67.6%, around 68% of the students do not afford original books. And some people, some students, they are not getting in the market, though they have the capability to purchase. Again, if we'll move into the another aspects about the photocopied of the books, I can remember my time, we used to photocopy the books very easily, getting from the library and sharing with each other, with friends. You see, these educational resources, original new books is purchased by the students only 7%. 73% of the students, like me, during my student career, we used to photocopy the books. I can throw a question to you. Let us think. What I was doing during that time, still it is practicing in some extent in the some places. I can put it in a note. If I'm looking into that practice towards the availability of the devices in use, please look into this graph, which is this survey is showing that maximum people, maximum students, they can purchase, they can have their smartphones. 95% they are having smartphones. You see, this smartphone can bring changes and now bringing changes in our teaching learning process. But we need to be very careful what cause we are having this discussion. Yeah, you can see here, maximum of students showing that the students are get access of internet from home. But today, if you will look into that, it may be that home, it means the internet facility, they are having their smartphones, but cost belongs to their own. So that's why, as we know that copyrighted things, it means it's completely closed. And we can mix that openness and open license. It will come that some rights resolved. Some rights resolved. My dear friends, let us see that how this some rights resolved. We need more sharing, reuse, remix, revise, redistribute, and retain. The content what we are getting at different platforms, in online or in offline, can these contents give us the opportunity to share with others with the privileging of these reuse, remix, revise, redistribute, and retain. Another characteristics of this some rights reserved is move towards the more scalability. Declining cost, which is zero marginal cost, as which is we are unable to look into the other side that we are unable to go for the reducing of the cost. Yes, more innovations. Derivative works possible. You have written something. If I want to read this and trying to make more good way to present for the wider audience, wider reader. So I need to have think more and more, and thinking level is increasing and thinking capacity is developing. Less time, faster production of resources, wider access to quality resources and data, because we can have the opportunity for the collaborative development of the content. Wider research experiences, which is data mining. Wider exposure of the writer himself, herself, rather than the publisher. We can understand this is the open and openness towards the development of the content with some rights reserved. I'm not talking about the copyright is not required. I'm not disrespecting the copyright. We are looking towards that copyright materials can be used in an open form which can reach to unreached. See, I can show you here some of the things which is why these some rights reserved or the copyright with open license helps us towards the development and openness. Let us look into the things. Closed one, closed materials, you can see cost is very high, less innovation as we understand. Access is very less. But in the case of just we are getting into the one step ahead, looking towards the openness. Cost reduced, innovation is increased, and access is increased. Here in this case, we can reach to unreached. If we'll compare with the user benefits point of view, look at very precisely it is written, the various features I have given here, you can look into the rights. See, all rights reserved, which is completely copyrighted one. But when we were looking towards the openly licensed resources with copyrighted, that is some rights reserved. Means we are giving opportunity towards the openness and giving opportunity to the users to use these contents. Permission? Yes, copyrighted material, you have to take permission. Otherwise, we will, if you'll cut, you'll be behind the bar. And open license, unless up until you are respecting to the license, working within the mandate of the openness, no need to take any permission from the author or the publisher or the owner. Reuse, not possible. But here in the case of openly licensed resources, yes, it depends upon the license. What kind of license you are using, particularly for the reuse, revise, redistribute, remix, retain, it is always important that you need to understand the different open licenses which is offered by the author, agreed by the author. Pre-use, yes, you can see. Pre-use is possible. Sometimes in the case of the copyrighted resources. But here, copyrighted with openly licensed or the open license, it is always. Open use, no, not possible, but it's always. Again, question comes, why consider licensing? Very simple way, if I will tell you, copyrighted materials, which is providing limited access to the user to use these materials. And we need to pay more and reach up to limited people. But if you look into the licensing is nothing, it's kind of understanding, kind of declaration by the author. Being an author, being a teacher, being an author, I always believe that my materials, my resources, my write-ups should go to the larger people. Then what effort I have taken before, what energy I have put into the producing of this material will pay off. More people can use my content, and other side, my contents can also revise, remix, and updated in the nature of the time I may not get in the future to do all these things. So my dear friends, the licensing is nothing, just giving you the importance for your implications of your content materials, which is copyrighted. So, an open license is any kind of license or the understanding that applies to the copyrighted content that allows you and giving opportunity to any user, any researcher, any earner, any teacher to reuse that content without asking or taking any permission from the creator or the author. But thing is that with ethical point of view, being a teacher, being a learner, I need to respect the license which is announced or the declared by the
So, sir, actually, to repeat, those who have joined little late, we are talking on open educational resources, and we have with us Dr. Banasanjan Panigrahi from SEMCA. And, sir, people are like continuously posting questions that how to, check whether it's copyrighted or not, or how it's free. I mean, quickly, while looking at any resource, how do we even know that it's copyrighted or open?
Yeah, thank you very much for this question, and I would like to address this question through my further slides. My further slides will give you the understanding about that, how to recognize whether it is copyrighted or not. That we will continue with in my subsequent slides, and we will discuss all these things. Thank you very much, Niti, for the giving me this question. Thank you. So let us understand that what is open. If you will open your door, you are inviting somebody at your home. If you close it, the person will come to your home, that will wonder how to knock you. And at that moment, they will find a bell. Then they will click on your bell. It means they are knocking you and getting permission, getting inside your house. So at that moment, if you want to allow, you will open the door and you can welcome and they will come inside. What do you mean by open here? If your door is open, it means you are allowing everybody come into your home. So anybody can come without permission. Or you can say that, giving a message, okay, my door is open, please come inside, but put your shoes outside. If you're putting some message over there, definitely people will act and respect accordingly. So this is nothing like we are thinking in a different way. Look into this, the entire openness and open license is talking about this 5R model. Very simple: reuse, revise, remix, redistribute, and retain. Reuse, it allows you use the content which is available. Revise, allows you to edit the content, adapt the content according to your requirement. Remix, content is there. You can put your own effort, and some other contents can be also put into and customized according to your requirement. Similarly, redistribute, already it has been distributed, your product can be distributed, can be shareable to others. And retain, you can keep it with you and make your own library. It allows you to do. So for all these things, if it is open, so no permission required, as long as you are respecting the license. You see here, there are many open licenses. Look into the C mark, copyrighted. It is copyrighted sign. Everybody's seen that copyrighted sign. My question here, that contents, any contents, which is available, is it copyrighted or not? For that purpose, one question for you, that is, ideas are copyrighted? If you will ask me this question, I may answer you, ideas are not copyrighted unless upon till it is shared with someone or written in the place. It means, listen carefully, I'm giving you an answer. It means whatever you are producing, by default, it is copyright. So whatever the content, whatever the page, whether it is written copyrighted or not written copyrighted, it is copyrighted by default. If I am writing in this page, I can show you here, if I'm writing in this page, I didn't write who is writing. I'm writing this page of content, which is whatever I have written, this is copyrighted by default. So all materials, whether it is available in the written form in a hard copy or in a soft copy or in the internet or in the any website, unless upon till it is given any open license, I can tell you the content or the materials or the educational things which is called as copyright. So by default, it is copyrighted. If you will put any open license into int along with the copyrighted, means you are talking about some rights reserved. It means, in other way, you can say you are opening up to your readers and your learners to use this material within this mandate and use these materials within this mandate.
So, the previous slide, can you just show us the previous slide that you had right now? Yes. So, all these symbols show that it's copyrighted image or open resources are there. What do all these symbols mean?
Copyrighted symbol is suppose that copyrighted one. These are the open licenses.
Copyrighted symbol, yeah. Right? And second one is?
This is Creative Commons license.
Creative Commons license.
Creative Commons license. This the third one is GNU, that which is for the software and technology rights provides, and the other one is likewise. So more or less we are using all these things. This is copyleft.
So second, that means please tell us that what all signs should we see among all these four so that we know that it's not copyrighted.
Yeah, it is copyrighted, madam. All content, copyrighted.
So
along with open license. It means, very simple what I'm telling, if somebody wants to enter to my home, my door is open. If I am written there, please, my door is open. If I'm not written anything, they can come into. If my door is closed, I am putting a bell. So they will click on bell. Then I will open my door. Then only they can enter in. Then so again, first, my door is open. I am putting that message. Put your shoes outside. Then come. So that it is understand that I need not want to tell them. They can read that one and respect my ideas, openness, and they will remove their shoes and get into my home. Very
so
simple.
Sir, suppose, for example, I click a picture of mine, photograph of mine, and I put it on social media like Facebook or Twitter or somewhere else. So is that copyrighted by me?
It is completely copyrighted by default. If
right.
I will use, so, I will take your permission, then only I can able
right, exactly.
So there are couple of things we will discuss. The four
points. Continuously, the questions are coming. So I'm just trying to.
Absolutely. This is very nice.
First symbol shows copyrighted image. Second is absolutely. Creative Commons. Third is GNU. And last one is copyleft.
Copyleft. Yeah.
Right.
Similar, we will discuss on also. Okay. Let us move to next. Close to open. We some extent understand about the open educational resources. This is the openness as we discussed, that this is the close to open. Very simple, whatever we discuss right now, I'm just showing here, you can able to understand, you can put your own logic over here, then we will discuss. Weak open. What is this weak open is? And strong open, what is strong open is? Weak open is talking about the open access. And strong open is.
I think the audio of Dr. Manas has paused a bit, I guess. Let us just check if he's there. Sir is there. He's logged in, but I think there's some issue with his audio. So by the way, I'm just repeating. By then, sir is just Dr. Manas. Sir, can you hear us?
Probably.
Yes, sir.
I think now it is okay.
Fine. Yes, sir. We can hear you.
Yeah. So look into this one. I can discuss with you this openness in two kind of. I am talking about weak open and strong open. In my view, open access is weak open. What does this open access means? If I am browsing your photographs in social media, I'm downloading your photographs from social media, that is providing me only open access. If contents are in any form in internet or informations, we are taking all these contents, which is giving you, allows you to just read and see, and you can download some extent. That is only talking about the open access. This is weak. It not allows you to revise, remix, redistribute according, which open license is giving you more opportunity. Understand that your content is completely copyrighted. Contents are copyrighted, but we are allowing them through certain licenses, through certain openness practice that you can use it. How you will use, what extent you will use, and what are the boundaries for that? That is mentioned in the open licenses and open access. Just as I just wanted to mention here.
Sorry to interfere, but then since we only have around 20 minutes now, we will be also having question round. So can you just quickly be a little fast and how to see whether it's not, how to ask for a copyright, how to, for suppose something is copyrighted, so how can we take permission and how to see, what exactly, which symbol to be used to see while we are accessing resources.
Yeah.
What are some of the OERs that we can find?
You please give me 10 minutes and we will reach to that level quickly.
Okay.
These are the 5R model, which is, we talked our slides, that is reuse, redistribute, revise, remix, retain, which is we are talking about telling that open educational resources. What is this open educational resources? It gives you free access, legal rights for this 5R. And it allows you to download. You can edit the content. You can make all this content in the open file format. For more about this, you can just run this movie. You can see this movie. You can understand. I have already submitted my slides to CIT and they will share it. This is completely OER. My content is completely OER. So these are the Creative Commons licenses. Creative Commons license, as we know, some extent that you can see here, this is a non-profit organizations which is coming to the picture and looking into the discussions we have, the problem we are facing that content can reach for the purpose of more access, good innovations, and less cost. That's where this organization come out with the different kind of licenses, which you can see and understand. If you are getting these licenses in any content or any website, any this adequately, which is available, that you can say that these are the open educational resources and OERs, which you can use it. This Creative Commons licenses come out with this six kind of license. You can look into that. CC means Creative Commons, which is brand, which you will get all the licenses together. And these symbols are talking about the openness you are offering being a copyright holder.
So those who are having questions on how to, what to look for and all those related things, you can please focus on this slide. You will be able to know from that here itself.
Yeah.
Go on. Yes, sir.
Okay. So the CCBY, you can look into that single wise. We will go move forward. These are the six kind of licenses. We will talk separately. And it is completely based upon the attribution, share alike, non-commercial, non-derivative. These are the four concepts they are using in the entire six. Attribution, as we know, we need to acknowledge to the author. Share alike, whose content we are using, producing our content, we need to the responsibility to share our content in that particular licensing. Non-commercial, you can use this content, but not for the commercial purpose, not for the getting any profit out of it. And non-derivative, it is completely closing you, which form you are getting this content, which is copyrighted. You can use it, means you can get the access into it, but you cannot change or you can not go for the revise and remixing all the 5 R's.
So, sir, which one will be the best one to use by us educationists? I mean, those who are in the field of education and all, which symbol to be looked for, which that will be the best for us to look for? I mean, which can you suggest?
It is every license has their own respect, own importance.
I mean, the safest
because we are dealing, being a teacher, I am dealing with the textbooks. I am dealing with the reference books. I am dealing with the photographs. I am dealing with the video contents. I am dealing with the research materials. I am dealing with the policy documents. I need to decide which content, which material should go in which license. That is depends upon the individual and depends upon the institutional policy. So let us understand about the each and every license, then only you can understand that which license can go for the which type of content.
So we will have to be a little quick because there are so many questions. That,
CCBY is complete open. CCBY is complete open. You can enjoy all the 5R, 5R model, all the 5R you can enjoy.
Right.
Moving towards the CCBY essay, it's more towards the copyleft, but copyrighted will be still there. And being an author, you can use anybody's content, author allows you to just acknowledge and byproduct whatever you are producing out of this content, you need to share with the same license. Here, it is just restricting some extent, that is called non-commercial, but byproducts should be shared with the same license. Again, this is same, CC BY, everything, but restriction is non-commercial. This is more restriction in the nature. You cannot do any derivative work out of that. You can't change anything. You can download, you can share, redistribute. You can even use commercial and non-commercial use, but you cannot change anything. If you are using my book, you can use my book as it is and sell my book and get the profit. That also you can do.
So, sir, sometimes it happens that some of the libraries or other institutions, they provide their content for free, to be accessed for free. But then can we download it? I mean, will that be...
Yeah, it can be downloadable and it can be usable. That is called open access. So right. In the open access,
we cannot tamper with it, right? We cannot modify
you
it.
You cannot revise, you cannot remix, you cannot adapt, and you cannot produce your content as your content using their content.
So that will be violating the copyright norms that we that they are having. So we can only download and read that, right?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. So,
two symbols is very important.
Uh-huh. Right.
These two symbols are very important. You can look into that. CC0. CC0 is completely public domain. Authors can produce their content. If I am producing any content, I can say that my contents are under CC0, means it's in public domain, completely copyright free. Anybody can do anything with this content. Similarly, public domain symbol also is there. So some contents are some period of time that is copyleft. So this, like Rabindranath Tagore's productions. In India, mm-hmm. it is 65 years, which is the time frame. After 65 years, the content is free and anybody can go for the translation, anybody can go for the production of movie, anybody can do, no permission required from the any liabilities. So this is very important. You need to understand that starting from the public domain to CC BY NC SA, these are the OER, and some extent it is not called as OER for rest of the two, which is list OER, list freedom is having. So that's where we...
So this is maybe answer to many of the questions that we were having, that how to, what symbol to use and how much freedom, how least freedom one offers. So you can, carefully look at these symbols, this slide.
Yeah.
You will be able to understand. And so suppose we are Xeroxing, in colleges, students Xerox a lot of books, and also ideally speaking, is that right thing to do?
No. This is really wrong. We are doing photocopy. That's why I have shown you some researches in my first slides.
And if we are, which is, many of us are posting the student images of students of our class on social media and all. So that is also, we are violating the copyright.
Absolutely, madam. Absolutely.
Since we have not taken permission from them.
Yeah, we need to take declaration.
Right, ideally speaking, need to be signed. Right.
Mm-hmm. Even if NCRT is conducting various workshops, you might have seen that NCRT has given the registration form where there is maybe the sentence or the point is that your photographs will be shared in any medium, and you are allowing us to take your photographs and sharing and through social media or any other respective ways. So that means you are allowing, you are declaring, you are taking permission from the author in the very beginning that use for the open license and copyright free, or copy holding the copyright with the NCRT or CIT.
Right, right. Sir, you can you suggest some sites who you that use?
Yeah, yes, I'm coming up. Another two slides, right, we will find out.
Right.
So public domain, CCBY, CCBYSA, CCBYNCs, as we understand so far, CCBYNCSA. These are the licenses which is you can choose more and most of the time for your different kind of contents. If you are providing any text-based content, video contents or photographs, I can suggest you go for the CCBY and CCBYSA more and more. It is more open. If you are sharing your research activities, policy documents, which need not want more changes, you can go for the CCBYNC, CCBYNCSA.
Right.
And CCBYND and other things, you can go for the PhD documents, PhD and any research output, patent things, that you can go for these licenses. So these are the licenses is more starting from the least open to the most open, which is giving you as open educational resources. This too is not OER, open educational resources. So these are the Creative Commons licenses, different codes. You can, this is self-explanatory, you can understand further. Due to time constraint, I am not putting much time here.
Yes. And we have to wind up now, sir, actually.
How to get this license? How to get this license? Just simply go, this is license, nothing sell out or nothing that you will purchase from somebody. No. This Creative Commons license, you can go to this site and these are the steps which is available on the basis of the concepts as I shared. Then follow these steps and get your own license, which license you want to. Out of this 6 and 4.
Right, license. So those who are asking how to find it, you just have to do these things. You have to go and then choose the, sir, can you just, yes, choose license features.
Just simply just browse with the creativecommons.org and choose your license. That is simple. You need to go for the step one, choose license features, allow adaptations of your work to be shared.
Right.
It means CC BYSA. Am I right?
Right.
Simply.
And so look for the CC BYSA licensing that it has. Select for that, and then you can press enter, and then you can get the access to those the resources.
Adequate license. And very simple is that if you will having, you need to understand what is this licenses. What is these licenses are talking about? If you know that one, no need to go for this process also. If you understand about the each and every licenses, simply you go, just take the screenshot of these icons and put it into your content. And just simply declare in your credit page, you simply declare that this content is released under this license under the 4.0, which is CC. So this 4.0 CC, what is this 4.0? These are the versions, different versions.
Okay.
These are the different versions of this CC. This is talking about the a more global license, rights outside the scope of the copyright, common sense attribution, and enabling more anonymity when desired. 30-day window to correct license violations. It allows you, if you are violating the license, 30 days time it is given to correct yourself if you are violating this license or any one of the license out of that. And increased readability, which is more focusing towards the disability point of view. And clarity about the adaptations, how you are adapting, what are the things you adapted, how you acknowledge out of that while you are taking into. Look into this video will help you a lot understanding about this 4.0. How when you will make your content, how you can revise and remix. That is more important chart you need to follow. The green ticks are talking about which license with which license is compatible. You can remix. If you are getting one video in CC BY and one text in CC BY SA, can we mix it? Yes, we can mix it. CC BY with CC BY SA, we can mix. But you are getting one content from CC BY NC, but you are having one content with CC BY SA. Can I mix these two license contents? No, I can't mix these two license contents. So this checklist, this chart will help you to really understand which license material can be mixable or the remixable and revisable with each other, taking into the consideration.
Sir, I think we need to wind up now because we are already it's already 4:28 p.m. and we have to stop it by.
So, this is more important that any person's content, if you are using, this is very much important. You need to acknowledge because each and every Creative Commons license is talking about the by means you need to acknowledge to the author.
Right.
That acknowledgement you need to use title, author, which source you have taken, and link, which is talking about the licensing about. So this is the game you can see, and you can understand that how to do all these things and how to mix and create your own content mixing of the all other licensed contents.
Right.
So this is instructional contents. This video also help you to understand about. And we understand today about the describing the openness in OER and creative different type of Creative Commons licenses, revising, remixing of the legal issues, and we can create open educational resources using that Creative Commons chart and understanding of this. These are the various kind of open educational resources.
Yeah, so see, this is an example. You can see those who are having questions. You can see here the examples of various open educational platforms that we have, you can access. Right? So I think
these are the various kind of repositories. If you want to identify images, this is the repository. These are the repositories you can get more and more contents accordingly.
Right.
So
thank you very much. Any questions? Sir. Yes, thank you very much, sir. It was a very informative presentation on open educational resources. And I understand that in 1 hour time or 40-45 minutes time, it is not and it's not possible to understand the entire gamut of issues that OER throws up to us. You have shared presentation with us. We'll surely share the same on our website. So I'll request all our participants to see our websites as well, so that if any other issue is left, they can refer these resources that we have at the website. And I'm sure Dr. Manas would also like to interact in formal or informal manner later on with the participants if they have any questions related to OER. So thank you very much. I would like to my special thanks to Dr. Manas for having agreed to come for this webinar, and my thanks to all the participants, and of course to my co-host and our technical team led by Ms. Sardar.